Hello, I'm Dr. Apurva Satish Amarnath. I'm a consultant in infertility with Nova IVF Fertility, the Kamanali branch in Bangalore. So today we are going to touch upon the common misunderstandings and myths surrounding assisted reproductive technologies that can encompass both IUI and an IVF. So a lot of couples have a lot of misinformation and a lot of apprehension regarding fertility treatment. So today we are just going to clear a few of them out today. So the most common one is IVF does cause a pregnancy in every single person. So this is not really true. IVF does increase the pregnancy rates for each couple compared to if you were trying naturally and have not been able to conceive also this long. But it does not cause a 100% pregnancy rate because this is dependent on the couple's age. The more the age, that is women's age more than 35 and the man's age more than 45, does decrease the chances of pregnancy even with an IVF treatment. Another misconception that is there is that every IVF pregnancy ends up in a twin or a triplet pregnancy, that is multiple pregnancies. And while IVF or IUI treatment does have an increased chances of multiple pregnancy because we are transferring multiple embryos, that is more than one, or we are creating more eggs in an IUI cycle, maybe two or three at a time. So there is a higher risk, but the risk is still only 10 to 12%. Compared to probably 5 to 6% in the general population. So every pregnancy with an IVF does not end up in a twin pregnancy. We have much higher chances of a single pregnancy even when we transfer two embryos. Another is the egg reserve, that is the total egg producing capacity is going to be depleted because we are going to remove all of it in the IVF. That is a very common misconception and people think that everything is going to be depleted as soon as we do this. So this doesn't really happen because what we do is we only grow the eggs that are already selected by the body and the hormones and the ovary to actually grow that particular cycle. So normally only one egg grows, but with treatment we are growing multiple follicles. So your entire egg reserve is not going to be reduced with that. Another misconception is there is a higher risk of birth defects or genetic defects in IVF born children. This is also not true. We cannot eliminate every single genetic disorder which can happen, but the risk of birth defects is basically the same as if the couple has conceived spontaneously on their own. What the risk of birth defects in them is the same with IVF. So there's no increased risk of birth defects with this. Another issue that people are worried about is whether fertility treatment causes cancer. There is no conclusive evidence that it does, and there is actually no increased incidence of cancers with fertility treatment. And the last one that a lot of people worry about is if we undergo IVF or an IUI treatment, will we not ever be able to have a normal delivery? Will it definitely be a cesarean? So there's no indication of cesarean for an IVF pregnancy just because you are an IVF pregnancy. And there could be cesareans for multiple reasons, like you have not progressed in labor or a cephalopelvic disproportion, whatever is there. But as such, IVF will not be the indication for a cesarean for you. Thank you.